Familiarity breeds contempt. And so what that means is what you become familiar with, you start to believe it's unworthy. It's just basic. It's not real special. And God just dropped this on my spirit. That's true about yourself. Like, you're familiar with yourself the most out of anybody, or at least you think you're familiar. You're the person you spend the most time with. And then you start to believe that, like, you just regular. You just everyday, regular, schmegular, degular. Like, you're like, really? Like, because you know, like, the things you do and the things you did. And so you're like, man, I ain't worthy of that. Like, and even think about the people you give grace to, but you don't even give it to yourself. Or how you're compassionate with everybody and you're not compassionate with yourself. You say things to yourself that you wouldn't say to anybody else. When you get like mad at yourself, or when you do something that isn't great. But other people do that stuff too. You're just not always there. But if they did and you knew they did that stuff, you would be so caring and loving and affirm to them that it's okay. Yet you don't give yourself that same grace. It's because familiarity breeds contempt. You're not just regular. You are who God says you are. God says you're fearfully and wonderfully made. God says you're beautiful, amazing, thoughtful, wonderful, terrific, divine, holy. Listen. You become too familiar with yourself. And you're actually perfect the way you are. Like, you, God don't play about you. He don't. And it's because you're great. I mean, you know what great, who do you think of when you think of great? You think of, like, I don't know, if you're a sports fan, Tom Brady, Serena Williams, you know? Like, you're that great. You have all of that within you. Like, you're great. It's you. So forget this familiarity stuff. Like, you're wonderful.